In Genesis 2, chapters 23 and 24, God says, "Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Years later, Jesus came along, and he held the honor of the institution of marriage to the highest honor. One of his first miracles was at a wedding. Actually, his very first miracle was at a wedding. It's my favorite, the water and wine. He told the Apostle Paul told us that marriage is honorable to all. The institution of marriage is not one to be taken lightly. It is not one to be entered into lightly. It is one of the most coveted relationships. It has to have respect, love, caring, and guidance. And most of all, it must have God. Crystal and Jonathan, your love for each other is like the Holy Trinity. With God on top and you two holding it up, it'll never break apart. Who gives this lovely young lady to be Jonathan's wife? God, we ask that you bless and look over this entire ceremony and the reception to follow, that we will turn up for it. But we ask that you not only bless the ceremony and the reception, but you bless the marriage. Because a love like this deserves the grace of God at their back.
Amen.
And Lord, we ask that you bless, look over the food and look over everyone that's in here tonight, and we ask that you keep us all.
It seems like yesterday we were standing at the bottom of the stairs at your sister's apartment. Palms beating fast, or palms sweating, and my heart beating fast, heart beating out of my chest when I asked you to be my girlfriend. Little did we know that on that day, November 22nd, 2012, we started a journey that would last our entire lives. They say time tells all, and these past 4 years have been, you've shown me love like I've never known. You're the best thing I've never known in you. March 19, 2016, we start the day of the rest of our lives. From this moment, you will never walk alone. Let my heart be your shelter. Let my arms be your home. With this ring, I give you all that I am and all I will become.
Years ago, I had honestly
Just yesterday, you and I were on the roof of our car, laying down, gazing up at the stars, talking about our goals and dreams. And now as I gaze into your eyes, I know that you're everything that I could ever ask for. Huh. And that everything that I searched for and prayed for. And you're my best friend. You're my family. And I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you, accomplishing all of our goals and dreams together. And I love you so much, Andrea. And I vow to always be by your side. And we're going to change the world together. It's you and me, now and forever.
I'll try. Into this holy union, Jonathan and Crystal now become joined. And if anyone here can show cause why these two cannot lawfully be married, the exit's over there. Get out. Long time coming. All right. Set her nails in for him. See, now this is a man. Now that Crystal and Jonathan have given themselves to each other by solemn vow, with the joining of hands and the receiving of rings in the presence of company and God. By the power vested in me, by the state of Florida, and God, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together.
What do you think, Papa?
Please join me in this prestigious honor of welcoming to the world Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan Fulcher.
Even when I lose, I'm winning, 'cause I give you all.
my granddaughter doing her thing. Me India.
Smoking that stuff.